Back to Dr. Nasreen's Academy. In today's video, I'll be discussing about clinical examination of varicose veins. So, before we start the clinical examination, we must know that what is a varicose vein. So, a vein is called a varicose vein when it is dilated and tortuous. And there are various places in the body where veins show tendency towards varicosity. For example, veins of the lower limb, spermatic veins, esophageal veins, and hemorrhoidal veins. But in today's video, I'll be discussing about only the varicose veins of the lower limb. So here is the picture of a varicose vein. You can see the dilation and tortuosity of the varicose vein. Next, a brief history is required before we start the clinical examination. Brief history mein sabse pehle hai age. Age mein, although it can affect all the individuals of all age groups, but middle age are more sufferers. If we say, see the female is to male ratio, then female mate is 10 times more common, 10:1 ratio hai. If we say the occupation, then prolonged standing, for example, drivers, or prolonged sitting, for example, drivers, or prolonged standing, for example, policemen, etc., and the person involved in the jobs, these people suffer from varicose veins. Also, varicose veins may also occur in individuals involved in excessive muscular contraction. For example, rickshaw pullers and athletes. So, occupation is also a very big reason or cause behind the development of the varicose veins. Up next is ethnic group, which is less commonly seen in primitive civilization. For example, the poor in Africa and Far East. So before we go to the clinical examination, we must understand the anatomy of the veins of the lower limb and along with the anatomy of a varicose vein. So we can see here that the deep veins mein iliac vein, it is divided into femoral vein, then goes to popliteal and then becomes tibial vein, and superficial veins mein it is greater stiffness vein, which is present medially in the lower limb, and lesser stiffness vein, which is present laterally and backwards of lower limb. Anatomy of varicose veins, normal direction of blood flow is one way or unidirectional, but in case of varicose vein, there is backflow. So normally blood moves through veins toward the heart by one way valves, which prevent blood from flowing backward, but in a varicose vein, the valves don't close properly, allowing the blood to pool and enlarge the vein, which can lead to painful skin ulcers. So this is the anatomy of the of a varicose vein. So these are the physical examination on inspection. On inspection, we can see a swelling which can be localized or generalized. We can see the skin color changes. First is phlegmasia alba dolens, known as white leg. This is due to swollen limb from excessive edema or lymphatic obstruction. And if second is phlegmasia cerulea dolens, which occurs due to when the skin of the limb becomes congested and blue due to deep vein thrombosis. So this condition is known as phlegmasia cerulea dolens. And the texture of the skin may be stretched or shiny, venous ulcer may be there, scar and pigmented skin may be there. Up next are clinical signs. So here we come to the main part of our today's video. Clinical signs may Trendelenburg Berg test, Brody, Trendelenburg Berg test 1 and 2. Next is Pathy's test or modified Pathy's test or Nyquist test, Schwann's test, Figan test and Pratt test. Let's see how do we perform these tests. First is Brody Trendelenburg Berg test. The test is performed to determine the incompetency of siphonofemoral valve and other communicating system. Brody Trendelenburg test जो है दो तरह से perform किया जाता है. दोनों ही method में हमें पहले करना क्या है. In both the method, the patient is first placed in the recumbent position and his legs are raised to empty the veins. दोनों ही method में हमें उनके legs में जो veins हैं उनको empty करना है. Empty करके the siphonofemoral जो junction है उसे compress करेंगे with the help of thumb of the clinician, या हम करेंगे, right? तो फर्स्ट मेथड में तो प्रेशर रिलीज करते हैं. इमीडिएट प्रेशर इज रिलीज, द वेरिसेस फिल वेरी क्विकली बाय कॉलम ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम अबव. अगर ऐसा होता है तो इट इंडिकेट्स पॉजिटिव टर्नल बर्ग टेस्ट बिकॉज इट इंडिकेट्स इनकम्पेटेंसी ऑफ द सिफोनोफ्यूमरल वैल्व. सेकेंड मेथड में क्या करते हैं, टू टेस्ट द कम्युनिकेटिंग सिस्टम, द प्रेशर इज नॉट रिलीज, प्रेशर को रिलीज नहीं करते हैं जब बल्कि इट वी मेंटेन इट फॉर अबाउट अ मिनट. देन ग्रेजुअल फिलिंग ऑफ वेन्स ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड इंडिकेट्स इनकम्पिटेंसी ऑफ कम्युनिकेटिंग वेन्स. सो ये है ब्रॉडी ट्रेडलर ब्लड टेस्ट 1 and 2. नेक्स्ट इज पार्थीज टेस्ट. पार्थीज टेस्ट एंड मॉडिफाइड पार्थीज टेस्ट, इसमें करते क्या है, द एफेक्टेड लोअर एक्सट्रीमिटी इज रैप्ड विद इलास्टिक बैंडेज. इलास्टिक बैंडेज या फिर टॉर्निकेट से हम रैप कर देंगे. विद द इलास्टिक बैंडेज ऑन द पेशेंट इज इंस्ट्रक्टेड टू मूव अराउंड एंड एक्सरसाइज. अगर क्रैम्प होता है, सिवियर क्रैम्पी पेन अगर प्रेजेंट होता है, अगर कंप्लेन करता है पेशेंट, देन इट इंडिकेट्स देर इज डीप वेन थ्रोम्बोसिस. मॉडिफाइड में क्या करेंगे, इसमें द टेस्ट इज प्राइमरीली इंटेंडेड टू नो वेदर द डीप वेन्स आर नॉर्मल और नॉट. तो टॉनिकोट को टाई करेंगे अपर पार्ट ऑफ थाई में, टाइट इनफ टू प्रिवेंट एनी रिफ्लक्स डाउन द वेन. द पेशेंट इज आस्क्ड टू वॉक क्विकली विद द टॉनिकोट इन प्लेस. टॉनिकोट रहेगा और पेशेंट को बोलेंगे कि क्विकली वॉक करे और जंप करे. If the communicating and the deep veins are normal, the varicose veins will shrink, whereas if they are blocked, the varicose veins will be more distended. So, zyada distended ho jayega agar varicose veins present rahega to. Usme bhi agar communicating or deep veins affected hai to. Up next is tourniquet test. It can be called a variant of Trendelenburg test. In this test, the tourniquet is tied round the thigh or the leg at different levels. After the superficial veins have been made empty by raising the leg in recumbent position, the patient is now asked to stand up. So on standing up, jis position pe hume dikhega varicosity, dilatations or tortuosity, that means ki us jagah ka, us area ka wo vein affected hai, right? Next is Schwann's test. In a long standing case, if a tap is made on the long saphenous varicose vein, here a tap is made in the long saphenous varicose vein in the lower part of leg. So, yahan pe an impulse can be felt at the saphenous opening with the other hand. So, this is known as Schwann's test. Up next is Figan's test. It indicates the site of perforators. In standing posture, line of varicosities ko mark karte hai with the help of a marker. The patient now lies down. Usko लेटने को बोलेंगे. द अफेक्टेड लिम्ब इज एलिवेटेड टू एम्प्टी द वेरिकोज वेन्स. द एग्जामिनर पैल्पेट्स अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ द मार्क वेरिकोसिटीज केयरफुली एंड फाइंड आउट गैप्स और पिट्स इन द डीप फेशिया व्हिच ट्रांसमिट द इनकॉम्पिटेंट परफोरेटर्स. मतलब पैल्पेट द कोर्स ऑफ वेन्स एंड आइडेंटिफाई एनी फेशियल डिफेक्ट्स साइट्स ऑफ इनकॉम्पिटेंट परफोरेटर्स. सो दैट्स हाउ फिगांस मेथड और फिगांस टेस्ट इज परफॉर्म. अब नेक्स्ट इज प्रैट्स टेस्ट. द टेस्ट इज परफॉर्म टू नो द पोजिशन ऑफ लेग परफोरेटर्स. फर्स्टली एक इलास्टिक बैंडेज जो है उसे अप्लाई करते हैं टोस से ग्रॉइन तक, और ग्रॉइन में एक टॉनिकोट को अप्लाई कर देंगे. इससे क्या होगा, दिस विल एम्प्टी द वेरिकोज वेन्स. द टॉनिकोट को उसी पोजीशन में रखते हुए इलास्टिक बैंडेज को हटा लेंगे. फिर उसी सेम इलास्टिक बैंडेज को वी विल नाउ अप्लाई फ्रॉम ग्रॉइन टू डाउनवर्ड्स एट द पोजिशन ऑफ द परफोरेटर्स. ब्लोआउट्स और विजिबल वेरिसेस कैन बी सीन ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसीजर. सो दिस इज नोन एज प्रैट टेस्ट. Up next is Morris's cuff impulse test. The limb is elevated to empty the varicose veins. The limb is then put to bed and the patient is asked to cuff forcibly. An expansile impulse is felt in the long saphenous vein, particularly at the saphenous opening if the saphenofemoral valve is incompetent. Similarly, a bruit may be heard on auscultation. So these are the clinical signs which is found in case of a varicose veins. So these are the classes, sequels of varicosity of lower limb, that is telangiectasia or reticular veins, which class 2 is varicose vein, class 3 edema, class 4 pigmentation or eczema, class 5 healed ulcer, class 6 is venous ulcer. So these are the sequel or the classes of the, or we can say that these are the complications of the varicose veins. So that's all for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.